The temporomandibular jaw joint, or TMJ, allows the mouth to both open and close. However, there are rare times when the mouth becomes locked in the open position due to a TMJ dislocation. In order to understand what's happening, as well as how to fix, normal jaw movement anatomy needs to be first reviewed. The key anatomic structures include the articular eminence, cupping the condylar process within the mandibular fossa. The coronoid process, although not a joint, is where the jaw muscles attach to allow mouth opening and closing. The first 2 centimeters of jaw opening is due to a purely rotational movement of the jawbone within the mandibular fossa. When the mouth opens wider than 2 centimeters, the jawbone moves forward and down along the articular eminence of the skull and out of the joint socket. A TMJ dislocation occurs when the mandibular condyle gets displaced in front of the articular eminence and becomes trapped in this position. The jaw is unable to close in this position because the coronoid process, which normally moves deep to the zygomatic process, is now hitting the cheekbone or maxilla. In order to reduce this dislocation back into normal position, the jaw must move downwards and back. However, this downward movement is not easy to accomplish because of the masseter muscle, which acts to keep pulling the jaw upward, resisting the downward movement that is required. As such, medications to relax the masseter muscle may be required, including propofol or benzodiazepines. Overall, the goal is to move the jaw downwards and back. Once the jaw has been pushed downwards, the chin is lifted upwards to complete the reduction. In order to perform this reduction, the doctor places the thumbs over the back jaw molars. In order to protect the thumb, gauze should be wrapped around the thumb. A strong and firm push is then performed, oriented both downwards and back. Once the jaw has been pushed downwards, the fingers closer to the chin then pulls upward at the same time, thereby completing the reduction. Afterwards, the patient should not open the mouth widely. At times, a chin strap or bandage may be required to help keep a dislocation from happening again. Eat soft foods to allow the TMJ area to heal. Apply ice to the area to help with swelling and pain. Finally, do follow up with a local dental oral surgeon for further management to prevent a TMJ dislocation from happening again.